Penske Truck Leasing employs thousands of maintenance technicians to keep its North American truck lease and rental truck fleet of 215,000 vehicles running smoothly. Every other year, the company holds an in-house event known as the National Technical Challenge, where top techs are challenged in a competition to determine the best of the best. It was created to provide maintenance techs with skills testing through hands-on and written assessments. There are two categories: a two-person vehicle systems competition, which measures knowledge of electrical and diagnostic systems, among others, and a solo preventive maintenance event, testing that a truck's operations are running correctly and that various parts are still functioning properly. The finals of the Penske 2012-2013 Tech Challenge were held in Winston-Salem, North Carolina in January 2013. An awards banquet took place at the headquarters of Penske Racing in Mooresville, North Carolina. The competition began in August 2012 with over 1,250 North American participants. In the end, there were 15 finalists vying for top honors. Bill Jacobelli, Penske's Senior Vice President of Maintenance, explains the importance of this event.
The Tech Challenge is held in order to help us properly position maintenance amongst all the other responsibilities we have within Penske Truck Leasing. You know, we're a large organization. We have multiple responsibilities to our customers and servicing those customers in the field. Foremost amongst those is really maintenance. And really to help us focus on key aspects of maintenance development for our technical personnel. It's very, very important to the DNA of the company, and we're just so glad that we're holding it again this year.
Greg Mangione is Penske's Vice President of Maintenance Services.
The Tech Challenge benefits Penske basically by reinforcing the learning process for our technicians. As you know, the technology on our vehicles is constantly changing. This forum motivates our associates to get engaged and to continuously learn about those improvements. I think this year we had over 1,250 technicians. Those folks have gotten brushed up on the latest and greatest in technology. Now, what does that mean? That means that we're delivering a more higher quality product that passes through our facilities, that's going to be more dependable for our customers. And when it comes to maintenance, what's good for our customers is good for Penske Maintenance.
Mike Hasanek is Penske's Vice President of Maintenance Systems and Support. After serving as a competition judge, he offered his analysis.
As usual, the competitors were nervous at first, but once they get engaged in doing their diagnostics and things along those lines, they settle down and get into their normal routine. So overall, it went great.
Two of the technicians competing in the finals, Ricky Sly and Tom Coxon, offered their thoughts on the event. They were winners of the Southeast region in the vehicle systems category.
This is my first year in vehicle systems. Made it all the way with Tom, so feel very accomplished.
It's awesome. I was in the finals in 04 also, so, and I don't get really nervous per se during the competition, which is good because he's a ball of nerves over here, and we kind of level each other out. We both know a lot of information on the trucks, and I can jump in and help him when I get stuck. He can jump in and help me when he gets stuck. So being the competition is a dual person competition is good, because a lot of times at the shop, when you get stuck, being able to ask your coworkers, hey, do you have any information, can you help me out, it's real good on that aspect too.
Mike Murphy, the PM event winner for the company's Northeast region, reflects on what it means to be a Tech Challenge competitor.
I was one of the individuals that was hesitant about doing this and never expected to make it this far. Just making it this far has been, an award in itself, to be able to come and, meet different people, learn different things from other guys from other cities and even other countries, with gentlemen from Canada that are down here with me.
The champs of the Western region, Mike Edmonds and James Gage, highlighted the benefits of teamwork.
I think it went well. I think it went really well. It was difficult, by no means was it easy, but I think it went well. I think we hit the points that we needed to, and caught the things that we had to.
Yeah, absolutely. The way they bug the truck, I mean, it's basically designed for us to follow a certain amount of procedures to actually find the bug on the truck. And I think we did really well doing it, so I feel comfortable with it.
You know, to get to this point, there's a lot of procedures that you have to follow. And, you know, learning those procedures and kind of help sharing it with him as we work together as a team and building off of both the knowledge that both of us have, you know, I think it benefits both of us that we become stronger, you know, that we become better technicians.
There were three winners at the Penske National Tech Challenge, a two-person vehicle systems team, and a solo preventive maintenance champion. The winners of the two-person vehicle systems competition were Bob Shaw, a lead technician in Canton, Ohio, and John Crawford, a lead tech in Oakwood, Ohio. Finishing first in the solo preventive maintenance event was David Bridgeman, a customer service representative working in Portland, Oregon. After the banquet, Shaw, Crawford, and Bridgeman talked about the joys of winning the Tech Challenge for the first time.
It feels great to win the Tech Challenge. I'm elated right now. I wasn't as nervous as I was in the last round, but you know, I was focused and just tried to get in there and do my job.
It feels good to win the Tech Challenge this year because this is my second time here, and to win first, I won third last time, so it feels like I made a great accomplishment.
It was winning the Tech Challenge is awesome. It's been a difficult time getting here, but I feel great about winning it.
Here are the placements of all 15 finalists.